It felt like five guys went and took on the world, and the world turned on them.
We're kids, and they hate us.
We're here to do one thing and one thing only, play softball.
It was our last summer together before we had to grow up.
People say, you know, I live in the ghetto. They call us, we're the end of the stick. In Arizona, that's how people refer to us. And, you know, I don't think the people that say that, if they came down there to live there, I don't even think they would be able to make it.
There's good people out there who come from Eloy. Community is more like, it's more like a family.
If you weren't playing sports, no one knew you. That's how Eloy is. You kind of fall off the map. You were really either a gang member or you were getting in trouble somehow, man.
Athlete from Eloy is one of five boys of summer playing on a co-ed softball team. The West team is currently in Kalamazoo, Michigan, competing in the Little League Softball World Series. The trouble is, the West team is the only co-ed team playing in the tournament. Only girls play on the rest of the teams, and this has some parents and players upset.
Not only are the boys outpowering them defensively and offensively, but now their pitching is not what we're used to.
This team and these players and these coaches really don't feel warm here.
It was all just supposed to be fun. This is real, like, these people actually hate us.
When they were saying we had black people on the team. I had a female and a male athlete who were black. And the female, she grabbed her bat bag and she was leaving. And an older man was trying to spit in her face.
There's a strikeout there. Put a K. Put on the gate. They stopped at three. And they had it. Big letters. Big signs. KKK. That's it.
We had a huge surprise. We were walking to the vans and a football team showed out of nowhere. What I saw showed up out of nowhere. Came around a building. And they wanted to beat our butts.
They were trying to pick fights with us.
Gates were shaking. Next thing I know, somebody just grabs me from behind.
The rules of Little League Baseball and softball says that boys can play softball. Mm-hmm. So boys are playing softball. What I'm afraid of is that someday we're going to have a team up here or wherever with 13, 14 boys on it.
All the crowd, they could yell as much as they want, but we're just staying the game.
We didn't go out there with the purpose of we're going to load a team with a bunch of guys and go beat a bunch of girls. We went out there because we wanted to play, because we wanted to have fun, and it was something we wanted to do.
On Wednesday, a team from Massachusetts faced off against the team from Arizona. Massachusetts player Sarah Purcell got an infield hit and slammed into an Arizona boy running to first base. The collision caused Purcell to twist her ankle.
I was scared out of my mind.
I feel real bad about how I cut it into that girl today, but they made it seem like it was on purpose. Yeah.
The coach of the team from Eloy, Arizona, with five male starters, says he had to recruit boys because too few girls showed up for tryouts. The rules have allowed boys to play since 1996. Some coaches say while girls can beat boys at softball, boys in the 14 to 16-year-old age group tend to be bigger and stronger than girls in that age group, giving them an unfair advantage and putting female players at risk of injury.
Female athletes in a wide variety of sports.
Amy Love, one of the first place to play when Little League Baseball changed the rule to allow girls in 1974, says safety is an excuse.
You're saying to those girls they are not good enough to compete with the boys. And, you know, 20 years ago we've been trying to break down these barriers, saying girls can in fact compete with boys.
Today, for the first time in the 26-year history of the Girls Little League Softball World Series, a team with boys won the championship.
We won a World Series. I mean, you can talk about that all day, but even in World Series of baseball and Major League, it's not the World Series. This will we actually beat every team in the world, the best players in the world.
You learn that no matter what you do or how you do it, there's always going to be somebody against you. And there's always going to be somebody there pulling for you, you know. You just got to be able to be strong.
I did everything for them. I wanted to go as far as they want. When they were ready to fold up and go home, I was ready to fold up and go home. But I wasn't going to back down on these kids. That was their dream. They were chasing it. And they got in with a hand reaching, and here we are.